Hey, it's Allison from computers.com with a quick video I've been meaning to make for ages because it's such a useful topic. Cut, copy, and paste. If you use a computer of any kind, sooner or later you'll want to grab some information from one place and put it in another. You could retype it, but that's tedious and it's easy to make mistakes. It's faster, easier, and more accurate to use cut, copy, and paste. There are a gazillion ways to use it, to reorganize the text within a document, copy information from one file to another, from one app to another, even to rearrange your files and folders. It all boils down to four easy steps: select, cut or copy, move, and paste. But many people are confused about it, and for good reason, as you'll see. So in this video, we'll try very hard to unconfuse the whole topic by showing you how it works with a bunch of examples, and you'll find a handy recap at the end of the video for quick reference. Let's begin with a very simple example. Say we want to move some text in a Word document from one place to another. We're starting with Word because it has these handy buttons for cut, copy, and paste right here on the home ribbon. By the way, people often assume that this little paintbrush is the paste button, but it's not. That's Format Painter, which is completely different. Before we get started, notice that cut and copy are dimmed, which means they aren't available right now, and if we click them, nothing happens. Why? Because they are only available when something is selected. So the first step is to choose the information we want. That's selecting. We can select a single word, like Liberty, just by double-clicking on it. The selection changes color, so it's obvious what is selected. Notice that as soon as we have something selected, the cut and copy buttons kind of light up. Now they're available. We happen to be looking at Word on a Mac. On a Windows computer, the buttons look almost the same, except you can see that the group of buttons is labeled Clipboard. That's because everything you do with cut, copy, and paste on any computer involves a special part of the computer's memory called the clipboard. In real life, the clipboard is invisible. You can't see it, and you can't see what's on it. You just have to trust that it's there. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to show the invisible clipboard so you can track what's happening more easily. There's nothing stored on the clipboard just yet. Now, if we're trying to move the selection somewhere else, we're going to click Cut, because that removes it from the original location. The selected stuff disappears, but it's saved on the clipboard. Remember, in real life, you will see the selection disappear, but you won't see that it's saved on the clipboard. Now, step three, we move our blinking cursor to the desired new location for this word. The cursor position determines where stuff will appear when, step four, we paste it. So that was cut and paste. Pretty easy, right? Select, cut, move the cursor to where you want the information to appear, and paste. Now let's try copy and paste, which is very similar. Suppose we want to write a happy birthday message and we want to repeat this whole line. Once again, the first step is to select the information I want. Last time we double-clicked to select a single word. This time we're going to click and drag to select the whole line. It's a little bit like stretching a rubber band. You have to start at one end of the stuff you want and then click and drag to the other end. If you start in the middle like this, you won't be able to grab both ends. So if you started in the wrong place, just click once to unselect, that is to release the selection, and start over. Once we have our line selected, this time we don't want to remove the original text from this location, we just want to duplicate it. So instead of using cut, we're going to use copy. Did you see what happened when I clicked copy? No, of course not, because copying does not change anything on the screen. I used to love to do this in class because nearly everyone thought they had done it wrong and clicked copy a few more times. When you click copy, nothing visibly changes. You haven't done anything wrong. Copy just remembers the selection by saving it on the invisible clipboard. Notice, by the way, that the clipboard can only hold one thing at a time. So the word Liberty we had cut before has now been replaced by the happy birthday line we just copied. Now we make sure that our blinking cursor is on the next line where we want the text to go and click paste to add the line to the document. Easy peasy. So as you can see, once you have something selected, you either cut or copy. The only difference is whether you're trying to remove the selection from its original location, which is cut, or leave it there and duplicate it somewhere else, which is copy. Notice also that the last thing we copied stays on the invisible clipboard. So if we want to paste it again, we don't have to do the select or copy steps again. We can paste repeatedly, like this. In fact, that last thing you cut or copied remains on the clipboard until you cut or copy something else or turn off the computer. So far, we've only worked within a single app, Word, and a single document. Let's take this to the next level. Now suppose we've written a long draft email in Google Docs, and we need to copy the text into an email. If you haven't used Google Docs, by the way, it's essentially a word processor like Word, except it's web-based. As you can see, Google Docs has a much more limited set of buttons than Word does, and there are no buttons for cut, copy, or paste. Again, people often think this button is paste, but it's not. That's Format Painter again. Since Google Docs doesn't have cut, copy, and paste buttons like Word did, we need another method. We need to use the Edit menu instead. When you open the Edit menu, you can see cut, copy, and paste are here, but again, cut and copy are unavailable because we need to select something first. Notice that also on the Edit menu is the option to select all. So if we're trying to select something long like this, it's much faster to use select all on this menu than it is to click and drag like we did for the phrase before. Scrolling up and down, you can see that everything in this whole document is selected, and it only took 2 clicks. Now that it's all selected, we return to the Edit menu and choose Copy. And all those pages of text now replace Happy Birthday on the invisible clipboard. Notice that although the clipboard only holds one thing at a time, it can hold very large things. Not just a few words, but thousands of pages, hundreds of files. It's practically unlimited. Unlike our first 2 examples, we're planning to paste all of this text into a different app altogether. So the move step isn't just a matter of moving the cursor. We need to open our email app and start a new message and go into the body of the email. Here's the blinking cursor right where I want to paste all of that text. Again, there are no obvious cut, copy, and paste buttons. So once again, we just go up to the Edit menu to find the paste command. And voila, there's all our text. Here are 3 important points about this last example. First of all, we followed the same 4 steps, but the 3rd step, move, can mean just moving your cursor inside a document or, as you just saw, moving to a different place altogether. Cut, copy, and paste lets us grab information, large or small, from almost anywhere and put it almost anywhere else on the computer. Second, you can use cut, copy, and paste buttons if the app you are using has them. That's very convenient. But if not, you will find the Select All, Cut, Copy, and Paste on the Edit menu of most applications on all kinds of computers. This has been a standard option in software for decades. And third, Cut, Copy, and Paste is not just faster in most cases, it's also reliable. You know that if you're copying and pasting a credit card number or some other sensitive information, the result will be accurate, no typos. So it should be clear now why Cut, Copy, and Paste is an essential tool in your tech toolbox. That was a lot to absorb, so as promised, here's a quick recap of cut, copy, and paste. The first step is to select the information you want. To select a single word, double-click on it. To select anything longer than a word, click and drag from one to the other. And to select everything in a given location, use Select All from the Edit menu. Once you have the selection, you cut or copy, depending on whether you want to leave the original item where it was or remove it. Then move your cursor to the place where you want to put the information, whether that's in the same document, or a different app altogether, and paste. Once you've got the hang of it, be sure to watch our next video that shows you how to cut, copy, and paste even faster and more efficiently using right-click and keyboard shortcuts. Thanks for watching! Please click like if you found this helpful. Feel free to leave comments and questions for us, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.